Hi everyone and welcome to another build tutorial. In today's video I'm going to be showing you how to decorate the interior of the farmhouse that we built last week. I'll link the tutorial for the farmhouse in the description if you haven't seen it already. I really hope that you enjoy this video and like how I decorated the interior of this house. Please leave a like and consider subscribing if you haven't already, and feel free to leave any feedback that you have in the comments section below. We're going to start by adding some detail to the entrance of the house. Add spruce planks all the way around the doorway and then place two columns of 4-block high oak logs on either side, mirroring what we have on the outside of the house. Join the oak logs together across the top and then add some extra logs sticking out at the sides and the front of the top log as shown. Then add two spruce slabs at the top of the columns with some upside down spruce stairs underneath to finish off the doorway. In the gaps that we have left at the sides, create some plants using a flower pot, a dead bush and an oak leaf block placed on top. Do this on both sides. Now, in the space by the windows, make a seating area using spruce stairs as shown, making sure that the stairs you place don't connect to the ones at the bottom of the window. Then make another plant using a cauldron with a leaf block on top, and after that add a spruce trap door in the corner with a lantern placed on top to look like a shelf. In the space opposite this, create a crafting area by placing a couple of chests with a crafting table in the middle. Then add spruce trap doors above this in each corner with a lantern and a flower pot on top with any flower that you like in it. For a bit more detail and colour, we're going to add a painting above the doorway. This can also be any painting that you like. After this, we're going to add some grey carpet in front of the doorway to create a doormat. And that's the entrance of the house completed. We can now move on to decorating the main room, which will be a dining room with several different crafting areas. To start, add some lanterns to the corners above the archways on both sides of the room and remove any torches that you might have left on the floor. Now, one block away from the middle window, remove 4 blocks of spruce planks from the floor that are directly in line with it. On the next 2 rows in front of this, come out by an extra block on each side, making them 6 blocks long in total, then remove another row of 4 in front of these. Now fill in the gap with sideways facing stripped oak logs in alternating directions to make a checkerboard pattern, as shown. Make sure that the logs are never next to another log that's facing in the same direction as it, so that you're able to get this effect. Once you've done this, add 2 spruce fences on either side, 1 block in from the edges of the 6-block sections. Then add spruce trapdoors on top going across to the other side to create a table. You may have to use temporary blocks to place the trapdoors so that they all face in the same direction and are all in line. As you can see, the trapdoors that I've placed are all facing the same way. Now add a chair on each side of the table using an oak slab with 2 oak trapdoors behind it. To place the second trapdoor, you just need to crouch. You can also place the trapdoor on top by jumping while crouching to get the trapdoor to face in the right direction. Now for some extra lighting, place a spruce fence on the ceiling in line with the ladder and the centre of the archway and hang a lantern from it. Repeat this on the other side, making sure that they're both in line. These lanterns aren't perfectly centred with the table, but they are centred with the rest of the room. After you've finished making the table, head over to the corner behind it where we'll be making a small brewing area. Make a table using spruce trapdoors on either side of the oak column, as shown. Then place a brewing stand on one side and a barrel on the other. Above the brewing stand, create a shelf using 2 oak trapdoors. Then place a chain hanging from the ceiling to look like it's holding the shelf up and add a flower pot with any flower in it on the other side. In the space opposite, in front of the window, add a crafting table to the corner and then make another table using spruce trapdoors next to this. Above the crafting table, create a small shelf using an oak trapdoor and add a flower pot on top with anything you want in it. Then place an item frame on top of the spruce trapdoor with a pickaxe in it for decoration. When you place in the trapdoors, make sure that they're on the top half of the block so that you're able to place objects on top of them by holding shift. Now, on the other side of the room, in front of the window, add a smithing table in the corner with another table made using spruce trapdoors next to this. Add a grindstone on top of the spruce trapdoor and an armour stand on top of the smithing table. You can decorate the armour stand with whatever armour that you'd like. In the final corner opposite this, we're just going to add some barrels and a chest for extra storage. To decorate, add the same shelf that we made on the opposite side using oak trapdoors, a chain to hold it up, and a flower pot on top. Then create a plant next to the chest using a cauldron and a leaf block. Now we're just going to add the final details to the main room. Next to the ladder, create a plant using a flower pot, a dead bush, and a leaf block. Then above the window, add any painting that you like. We're now going to repeat this on the other side, so add a plant next to the ladder and a painting above the window. I'm adding so many plants and flowers because it's a farmhouse and I want it to be full of life and colour. Now the main room's done, we can move on to the rooms at the sides. This first room is going to be a kitchen area. So, one block away from the window, add a smoker on both sides with a cauldron in the middle, which will be filled with water. Above the smokers, add an open oak trapdoor to look like the top of a cooker, then place spruce slabs on either side to create a worktop and add a lever above the cauldron to look like a tap. After this, add some grey carpet in front of the smokers. Then, make a shelf using spruce trapdoors at the top of the window and add a lantern on top. This will light up the whole room. In the corner, place a scaffolding, then add a barrel on top with a tripwire hook on the front of it to look like a keg that would store drinks. In the other corner, add a couple more barrels for storage and then add a trapdoor above this in both corners to create small shelves, making sure that they both face in the same direction. On top of the shelves, add flower pots with anything you like in them to add some colour to the room. Now, for a bit more detail, we can add some item frames to the walls with food in them and some sea pickles on top of the spruce slabs to look like small pots. Feel free to use any of the food types, it doesn't have to be exactly the same as mine. Now that the kitchen area is done, we can build a smelting area in the other side room that we have left to fill. So, to create the smelting area, we're going to start by adding three furnaces to the middle of the back wall. On top of the furnaces, add stone brick stairs as shown to create a chimney. Then remove the spruce slab on the ceiling in the centre and add a stone brick wall here to finish the chimney off. Add stone brick slabs on either side of the furnaces to create a work surface. After this, add an extra spruce slab in the corner of the ceiling and create shelves at the top of the window on both sides using spruce trapdoors. Once you've built the shelves, on one side add a lantern, a barrel, and a chest for storage. On the other side, add a chest, a barrel, and a flower pot with anything you want in it. In the corner, add a crafting table, then make a small table next to this using spruce trapdoors. On top of the trapdoor, add an item frame with a sword in it for decoration. Now, on the other side of the room, add an anvil in the corner with a chest next to it, and that's the smelting room completed. If you'd prefer, you can use one of these side rooms to make an enchanting room, as this would also fit into the space. I just made a kitchen and a smelting room as it fit with the theme of the farmhouse better. We're now going to decorate the upper floor. Starting on the side walls, add three upside down spruce stairs below the window with spruce trapdoors on either side to create a shelf. Then repeat this on the opposite side. This adds a nice transition between the wall and the window here. Now, once you've built both of the shelves, add a lantern on top of one of them with a flower pot next to it. Like the rest, you can add anything you want to the flower pot here. Underneath the shelf, add three spruce planks with a spruce slab on top of the middle plank. Then add two more slabs in front of the left and right planks and place a bed in the middle. After this, add a lantern for some extra detail and then place an ender chest or a normal chest in front of the small window. Finally, create a plant using a flower pot, a dead bush, and a leaf block in the remaining gap. Now, above the ladder, create a shelf using spruce slabs with a spruce trapdoor in the middle. On top of the shelf, add some chests and barrels as shown for storage space and decoration. Repeat this shelf design above the other ladder. This time, place in the barrels and chests so that they mirror the ones on the shelf next to them and aren't exactly the same. Now, in the space between the ladders, you can add some stacked double chests in the middle and surround them with spruce trapdoors for some extra detail. The trapdoors make it look like the chests are part of a shelving unit. On the wall opposite this, we can put two sets of stacked double chests side by side as we have some extra space here. Just like with the chests opposite, we're going to surround these with spruce trap doors to make it look like a shelving unit. On the wall above this, next to the window, create a shelf using spruce slabs with the trap door in the middle again. Add a barrel on top and a flower pot with any flower in it for decoration. Then repeat this shelf design in the gap on the other side of the wall. Make sure it's placed on the top half of the block so that you're able to place objects on top of it. Add a lantern to this one for extra lighting. In the remaining space below the shelf that we made earlier, place a lectern and add an upside down spruce stair on either side to create a desk. Now, using temporary blocks, add a small painting behind the lectern for an extra bit of colour. After this, add a spruce stair that's facing towards the lectern to create a chair. Then place a book and quill on the lectern and add a lantern to finish off the desk. To decorate the shelf above, just place a flower pot with any flower in it. After this, add a spruce trapdoor to the corner and place a lantern on top to make sure that it's all well lit. Then add a chest on one side of the desk and a plant on the other using a flower pot, a dead bush and a leaf block. And that's the whole interior of the farmhouse completed. Feel free to change anything that you like and add or remove certain sections if you think that something else would work better for you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video and it's given you inspiration on how to decorate the farmhouse. Please leave a like and consider subscribing if you haven't already to see more content like this, and feel free to leave any feedback or suggestions in the comments section below.